Hello and welcome to PGurus channel. I'm your host, Sri Iyer. And today we have Professor R. Vaidyanathan. You see, we are making up for some lost time with Professor RV. He was busy with other things. So we decided, you know, the viewers, you always love to listen to Professor RV. So we have come today with a very weighty topic, the effect of social media on India's politics and on India in general. Professor RV, welcome to PGurus channel.
Yeah, this social media, not only on India's politics, it is also on the Indian general media, what is called mainstream media, how it has, in a sense, destabilized, actually. This social media, of course, a lot more have to be understood, and it's relatively young, and it's also very rebellious. And it is, in a sense, uncontrolled also, except by the owners of the social media. Actually, what is happening most important is the influence of the net to start with. I think internet has created havoc in the on various aspects of human life.
Sir, in startup parlance, it's called creative disruption.
Yes. And this is what has happened actually. Now, slowly the print reading is coming down actually. Some of the, not that earlier it was great or anything in a country like India. Like one of the very renowned poets is no more, Gopalakrishna Adiga of Kannada literature. He is a very well-known person. He once told me in a conversation, he was in Bangalore nearer to my home. So he once told, Professor, we were talking of that time there was some issues of this Kannada getting primacy and Sanskrit should not be the main language and all that was there, and there was some other side issue of Kannada and Tamil also at that time. Anyhow, we were talking, he told an interesting thing. He told one thing, is very common among, Kannada, Tamil, Telugu, all these languages, Hindi, all these languages, he says the good books written in these languages nobody buys. he told me that a lot of shops have huge accumulated Kannada books of very renowned scholars, not just him, various other scholars like Kuvempu, like himself, and he was naming so many people. He said nobody buys them actually. So, but there is a huge clamor and shouting for that. Same thing in Tamil also. A good scholarly book, people are not. And now post net, even the non-scholarly book, people are not buying actually. All those books which are sold on, exposing skin and spin, even that is not being popular. Now, net has comprehensively replaced the printing media. The other day, I'll tell you, one 10th standard boy, I gave him some material, a couple of pages, not even huge material. Then while leaving, he told, Uncle, can you send it by mail to me? He doesn't want to carry that 3-4 pages and read it. He says he is more comfortable reading in the screen. That is the See, long time before, there is an anecdotal evidence, or rather a thing used to be told, that when the first print came in Germany, they began to print a Bible, actually. And there were a lot of material which were on parchment, which were on, cloth, various other forms of writing used to be, palm leaves. They were all very popular. And priest wanted all of them to be put into printed form. And all the, Bible, I think everybody is aware, doesn't have only just one version or one edition.
There's the Old Testament, New Testament.
And within New Testament, there are many type of interpretations. And he wanted everything to be put in. Then the others were telling, are you mad or what? Why do we have to waste our time? He told, look, a time will come, very prophetic, a time will come where everybody of importance will be in print. And if something is not in print, it is not of importance for people. So this is what has happened actually. Now, you know, except some research scholars, nobody reads palm manuscripts or, and you know, same used to be told about our Mahabharata actually, you know, by many people. If something is of importance, it is in Mahabharata. If it is not in Mahabharata, it is not of importance. Don't worry about it. Like the same way, this internet has replaced that saying. If something is of importance, it will be in the net. If it's not in the net, don't simply bother about it. It's not relevant or it's not required. To that extent, we are moving. And so the explosion of the social media is linked to this. But for the arrival of the net, we would not be having so much amount of noise on the social media side. Social media, of course, encompasses so many things. It talks about Facebook, you can talk about Twitter, you can talk about WhatsApp, you can talk about Instagram, so many things. But the common aspect of it is, it has hit the what is called the mainstream media, particularly the news media, the printed news media. It has hit heavily. The traditional print news media nowadays, very interesting. A lot of these printed paper, if you read, they take a lot of it from the Twitter and other thing and then publish it. That XYZ has told this in the Twitter and then they publish it. That is one type of a thing. Why the printed media has lost its thing is three, four important thing to note. Originally, printed media depended on advertisement. If you go back to the 50s, actually, very interesting. I was going through the copies of the Southern paper, the Hindu of the 50s. Many of them had first page fully advertisements only.
In 50s?
Yeah, 50s. In the film advertisement, advertisement on blade, advertisement on discount on some chocolate. It's a very interesting thing. It's a full, you know, page is full of advertisement. And if you can just, you know, just wait for a minute.
Yeah.
Given a gift by the newspaper Hindu of 1951, one first page.
Okay, can you bring it? Yeah.
You wait. Can see that.
Yeah.
The first page is only as.
That the first page is like that. That's amazing.
See, this is a. Or Jupiter's Kaidi, one film which is expected to be released. That is the main advertisement. And it has a lot of it. Hamlog, then engineering company, rubber estates, then Mane Vilak, somebody has advertised. Price is rupees 3. He wants to sell the, that is the scenes from Sangam literature. Then Sindhya Navigation Company notice. Then Kali, many of them are actually film advertisement. So what I want to, I just wanted to, I think you could see this, right?
Yeah. It's very, well visible, well visible. Yeah.
So that used to be the format. And now, 80s and 90s, it changed. You know, the ads went inside another. Now you find first 2-3 pages, sometime in Times of India, quite a number of pages are advertisement only. Their argument is we earn something like 90-92% from advertisement, sir, not by circulation.
Vineet Jain, in a moment of candor, said that we are in the business of advertising, not news.
Correct. Actually, they went to some extreme wherein they told every inch column space of their paper is for sale. Pronounced. Anyhow, so that is what is happening. Now, my own hunch is, already they say 92-93% comes from advertisement. So my own hunch is, maybe within the next couple of years, 5 to 10 years, the newspapers will only be having advertisement and it will be, I think in US you would have seen, I'm sure in many of the, train, stations and public places, I've seen from papers being given free. It contain only ads and some small, the news item, very, that's a local something, you know, about some function somewhere or something. Otherwise, it's full of ads. And also many of those ads, if you, they say if you cut it and take it to the departmental store, you will get some
clip-on coupons.
Coupons, they are called. So I think most of our mainline media will also become like that. Why there is such a change is, a couple of things have happened. One is, most of these mainstream media, you know, India, all over the world, is controlled by, you know, some business group or something. This is, they will claim independent, but that's very rarely the case. So what happened is, they used to have a slant and they used to focus on sales. Very interestingly, even though it was controlled by business group, it was run by left liberals all over the world. Because most of the journalism schools, like, you know, the what one can call the mother of journalism school, like Columbia, and the middle, then you were London, so many places, they had a huge number of these left liberals, you know, as trainers, as professors, and other things. So many of the students also, you know, got attracted towards it. For instance, from India, you have the Enram of the Hindu, then Barkadat. So many of these people were all trained there. And particularly those who got trained in the 70s during the, you know, peak of that anti-Vietnam, you know, what fervor. So all these people began to occupy the positions of editors and sub-editors and other things over a period of time. The owners were not very, you know, worried about it. In the sense, as long as the sales were maintained, they were not very sure. As one of them quipped, actually, I don't read my newspaper. One of the owners, if I remember, maybe Vinit Jain or somebody seriously quipped that I don't read my newspaper. Why do you waste your time type of thing in an aircraft conversation? Anyhow, so this is something. And in the process, what happened? It's always a one-way type of a communication. This is very, very important. They used to write and people have to read. And you can send letters to editor or something. May or may not be published. In many cases, those which are praising them will only be published. Those who are criticizing them will not be. So quite a lot of people were very upset, actually. If I remember, in the net some 10 years before, some sort of hundreds of letters somebody has published, which were not published in the Indo. So he sort of in a fit of anger or something, all of them on various topics at various points of time he has written, and which were never published. So this is the one of the major issues.
So he published a book? Did he publish a book? Did he publish a book?
Book he should have published. I don't know, but I saw it was in the net. Anyhow, that's a good idea actually, to publish a book actually. I used to have something like 200 or 250 like that. I never published any of that, which were, you know, sent to the newspaper. The point is, it became a one-way communication, which was first area of problem. Second was, slowly these papers, because of their, you know, competition and you know, advertisement thing, began to also focus on what is known as the paid news. You know, if you pay a certain sum of money, then that news will get a prominence. So this was also accepted, actually. Paid news was also accepted. For instance, today you find significant amount of news coming about this on a regular basis about this Priyanka Chopra and that Jonas whom she is expected to marry. Every day when news comes about how she is smiling, how they are walking, how they are, you know, all that. It's simply some you know, what do you call a relationship person or some agent, I'm sure, manager would be handling that. I'm sure certain amount of money has to be. Same thing about that kid of this Saif Ali Khan, who is named as the Timur. Timurlane was one of the greatest barbarians who butchered millions of people. I do not know why they got the... He also killed his own parents. I'm very worried about it. That is one of the things. Actually, when he came of age, he just killed his mom and father. Anyhow, when he burps, when he sneezes, when he laughs, when he smiles, all photos of him every day in the Sun Times or Times of India, DNA carries. And I am also sure there is somebody, you know, manager or something. What I want to stress is, one senior official of one of these papers told me openly some 5-6 years before, Professor, you have something like 10 lakh. I asked him, what for? If you want, you give it to me, to our paper. Then every week, one article will come about you. That you are a whiz kid, you are doing this, you are doing that. Students are happy about you. And somewhere something you have published, we will highlight that. How it is changing the entire, you know, economic thinking. Or he openly told, but 10 lakh, I told him, are you mad or what? No problem, we will reorganize it, don't worry. You will become a talking point for some time. Then what happened? And then he told, you know, you may get back your 10 lakh also, he told. That is, they may take it in the form of fixed deposit or something and then return it. So this is the type of a paid news thing which became a very, you know, it became a disease actually. And the visual media, that is the television media, began to provide competition to this traditional print media. But television media has its own problem in a country like India, for instance, where there is nothing, you know, in US, for instance, there are many television channels which will focus only on national and international aspects. For instance, New York Times based, you know, channel, or even your CBS or NBC, they won't focus. If some lady get, you know, what one can call attacked in the roads in Alabama, I don't think they are going to. It will be covered by the local Alabama. And if it is a very major issue, then they may get a feed and then they will use that. You know, WW Alabama given feed like that. Otherwise, national channels focus on national news and international. And the local channels are plenty, as I think you are aware of it. Every state has got some. And they focus on. Here, what happened, unfortunately, this distinction is not there. So even if one lady somewhere in a dark alley of Haryana is you know, robbed, it becomes a national news. And immediately after that, Trump news comes. And Modi, you know, this national so-called television channel are so confusing between local news, regional news, national news and international news. So there is a huge problem with the television channel, but still they give good competition to the print. Some of the print fellows have gone into television, like India Today, then your Times of India and others have gone into television. The second aspect, which is much more pernicious in this paid news, is something called paid unnews. That means you get paid for not publishing some news. You know what happened?
This goes back to R.K. Karanjia.
Worst thing actually, more than that. This Times of India used to have what is called the contracts with the large, I think last count, if I remember, 120 or so companies. In one in which I was on the board, this proposal even came. The idea is very simple. They will, you know, you don't have to, you have to pay in the form of, you know, units of share in your company for the ads and other things. It's not in the form of cash. And these will be mostly, just one second.
Yeah.
Hello. How are you? Yeah. No problem. Come on. I just wanted to check, you know, November 1st, I wanted to travel in the morning. I was seeing the net, all of them is closed. I'm very puzzled actually. So, sure, maybe after an hour or so, right? No problem. Yeah. You can call me around 11:30. No problem. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so they have this contract. I think they give some name for it. Anyhow, with 110, 120, what this essentially implies is for the ads, you don't have to pay and we will have it in this form. And whenever your group company goes for public, right? They will get a benefit if it is going at a more than par, you know, premium, for instance. 10 rupees share is sold for 20 rupees, then Times of India will be able to offload it in the market and make the gain. This is the deal. But this is not a pure economic deal. There is a catch. What is the catch? Or rather a benefit they are giving to the these people. If there is any bad news about them, by and large, it will not be published. So how I came to know is, I told you, one of the firms I was with, this proposal came, we rejected it. I told prima facie, it's stupid. More important is, there was one of the major construction site, one lift got crashed at the time of construction, and 6-7 laborers actually died. It's a very, very sad state of affairs. Many papers covered and some paper did not cover. I was puzzled actually, because this is generally of, you know, city news column, and in the city news, 7 or 8 people is not a small number. Then I inquired about it. I was told, no, this part of the deal. So some of these, so this bad news or whatever you call it, wrong news, suppression is much, much more prevalent nowadays. So it is two things, paid news and paid unnews. So what happened is, the reliability of the papers have significantly come down compared to, say, something like 20 years before. In those days, you know, you can straight away, even in US, I'm told that of New York Times and Washington Post is not what it used to be in the 80s and 90s. You know, in the sense, today you can't say that it has come in NYT, so, you know, automatically people will question that also. So to that extent, but in India, it is very sad state affair. So what has happened? This combination of arrival of net, the left hold on the editorial and other policies, and one-way feedback. Three is paid news and paid unnews. All these put together as cocktail it has stirred, and this social media has exploded. And initially, you know, there is so much amount of what you may call hatred poured on the mainline media by the social media people, both in Twitter as well as in Facebook, everywhere. And they began to what you may loosely call rebels without a pass. They began to expose. Some news was, you know, will be wrong, and they will say that. So like this, like that. And so many of the mainstream media began to get slightly worried actually. They began to exercise more caution. And the social media more reflected what you may loosely call in the Western parlance, the right wing, compared to the left wing of the mainline media.
So that is probably only in India, right? Because in India, media is mostly left, isn't it? Or is it true worldwide?
No, India, sorry?
Left liberal, more.
Yeah, all over the world it is same, similar. It's not the ownership. Again, let's be very clear. It is much more the editorial and other team.
The rank and file.
They've all been trained by schools which are having professors who are left-oriented. So they have, you know, imbibed those qualities. Liberty, equality, and generally, you know, that you should be pro-homosexuals, pro-minorities, pro... For instance, the British media, except one or two of that, the Sun and Express, that type of thing. British media, is, by and large, is... extremely towards what you may loosely call the multiculture, for instance. If somebody criticizes multiculture, there will be UN cry. German media also, same way, actually. But the social media is much more the other side, not so left. And in India, of course, the other division is also there between what you may loosely call Hindutva type of social media barriers. So they also began to flourish. They identified that this mainline media is taking stand, which is not conducive to Hindus. It's much more, you know, in terms of derogatory and other things. That's how this, for instance, a recent, the eruption of anger toward this Sabarimala judgment, where the mainline media is not even covering the huge amount of processions and other thing which is being organized. If I take the last 2 days of the print edition of Times of India or Hindu and other thing. There is not much coverage at all. I think this is on the other side, other extreme actually. There is no need to not to cover it. You can cover it, you can criticize it and other thing, but not covering also. So this is what has made the social media warriors, I would call them, as actually one of the, what one can call, ladies, I think, Sagarika Ghosh or something. She called them as what you call internet Hindus. What IH, that's the name she gave it or anything, which has been very proudly accepted, and now they themselves use that word. When you use some word in order to abuse somebody or something, they take it very, you know, jovially, and then they begin to pronounce themselves as that. So this is what has happened, internet. So this is another very, very huge and it has its own minuses. Major minus is it carries all sorts of news. There is a, you know, humor about WhatsApp University. Did you graduate from WA University? Because lot of news which comes there is not very reliable, and that is being passed on from one to another. Suddenly some news will come that, you know, government, for instance, recently there was a news item telling 1 week banks will be closed. That fellow, whoever sent it, he mentioned one day for this, one day for that, one day for RBI strike, one day for Krishna Jayanti, whatever. And that spread like wildfire to the extent Minister of Finance has to come forward along with the All India, this bank federation, telling that this news is not correct and we are not closed for a week. We are open for, actually we are closed for one day or something like that. Now what I want to stress is, this type of thing is also very, very common. The second type of thing is, lot of photoshopped items are also spread in the process. It will suddenly be, you know, in one photo, you know, Modi will be, you know, embracing some Islamic leader, and then there will be a lot of criticism that why should he embrace that. Then much later it will be found out he has not embraced him at all. He was neither Modi nor the other follower. So this, what is called the Photoshop is, and this more popularly come in what are known as memes. That meme, you know, that type of a thing. So this also spreads lots of what you may loosely call the false news or fake news. And, you know, it become a bit difficult. Unlike in a regular printed newspaper, there is somebody called the editor, sub-editor, and all those fellows are paid in order to sort of look at all these things and then decide. In the social media, there is nobody is there actually. It's a free-for-all. But still, there is a broad thing. For instance, Google, you know, I think you would have read about it. Even Trump says Google is extremely pro-left. It censors only news item pertaining to the right. That is the Trump is extremely upset about many of these major news media. Yes.
By the way, Trump started out as a Democrat. Please continue.
Yeah. That's correct. Original. Right? Yes. And there are some people who still argue Trump is not Republican in that sense of the term. He's only an independent, right? So who latched on to the Republican bandwagon. In the sense, he's not one of the, what you may loosely call the blue-blooded Republicans, right? In that sense of the term. He was independent for quite some time. Anyhow, he says Google is extremely partisan. And he also says the same thing about this Facebook, as well as about this Twitter. And at least in India, Twitter has been proved to be more pro-left. They have, you know, they have really censored quite a lot of so-called, quote-unquote, non-left type of tweets and other things. And there is some lot of complaints about these ownership also. For instance, many people complain that we tweet and all our followers don't get what we tweet. It doesn't go to all. There is some sort of a shadow, like a person like
a shadow ban.
Tommy, he has complained that he has got some million followers, I think. And it appears that all his tweets don't go to all his followers. It's some sort of what you may loosely call regulated or censored or whatever it is.
Sir, so, if you ask me what Twitter and Facebook want to do is they want you meaning Dr. Swami, they want Dr. Swami to pay Twitter/Facebook so that his tweet or post will reach his followers. They're trying to monetize even that.
Okay, okay. So if you pay adequately, then there is no need to worry about it.
Yeah, but then what is the point of saying that you have 7 million followers? In fact, Dr. Swami has 7.4 million followers.
Oh, okay.
And then they don't get his tweets. They have to go to his timeline and then look up his tweets there.
Right. Oh, okay. That what? So there is a, what you are telling it, there is a provision for paid news there also.
There also, exactly.
You pay and your news get disseminated, right?
Right.
Something like that. Yeah.
Right.
So, but it has opened up a, I do not know. Some people say it has opened up a can of worms, but some people say it has opened up a huge opportunity for people because, you know, for instance, everybody is now a publisher. He publishes in his Facebook some one page write up on, you know, why the world should come to an end soon, or, you know, why women are all, you know, dangerous, and any type of topic they publish. And then after some time, you know, some people criticize it and then they withdraw it. All sorts of things is taking place. So that is a, so the power of the social media has come to stay. My only complaint is we have so much amount of billionaires and millionaires and, you know, it comes about. But none of them has taken any interest in creating our own, what you may loosely call, equivalent of Facebook and Twitter and other things. Because we are one of the largest subscribers in the world, actually, for these things. May not be the largest, but one of the largest. In terms of numbers, I am talking about. I do not know why none of our industrialists or big business or anybody has shown interest to. I am sure technologically it is not an impossible task. If given a, you know, enough amount of funds, we have enough talent to create our own. I think that would have been a much better idea instead of, you know, using China, of course, off and on imposes restriction and other thing, which interestingly is accepted by these social media fellows, maybe because of the size of the market or whatever it is, right? But
right.
Yeah, I don't think, you know, I think we should be, my own feeling is we should have our own, you know, it's much better if one of the Marwaris, you know, censor your thing rather than, you know, the Amazon or Google fellow sitting somewhere else and, you know, not that the Marwari fellow is going to censor. As long as there is enough traffic, I think he won't care. But I do not know why you have any clues. Why none of our big business has shown interest in this?
Sir, our software industry is really creating only people who can maintain somebody else's software. We have not really done any ground-up work. The ground-up work that I can think of happened in one company, which is the Financial Technologies Industries Limited, in the server, stair, e-trading platforms. And thanks to some politicians, even that has, you know, been challenged quite a bit. It's coming back.
Originally, there was supposed to be some Kanna or somebody, right, who worked in that and he gave something to NASDAQ also, I think.
Yeah.
Some name I don't recollect. Anyhow. Yeah,
there is one other software company that had very good software called LaserSoft out of Chennai.
Yeah.
They developed the first core banking system modules that shares by even today. Suresh Kamat was the name of the founder. He was a M.Tech from IIT Chennai, IIT Madras. And he employed, at the time of the company being sold, he had 40% people who were physically disabled.
He really
had a mission in life that he said, you know, for me, I want just brains, people who can think what can be done.
Right.
And as long as the public sector undertaking banks used his software, they never had this PNB scam-like thing. It is only after the switch happened that all these problems happened.
Right.
I mean, I've written about this extensively. So my point in saying all this is that India still has to go some distance before they can start making software from ground up. Flipkart is maybe one example. Other than that, I'm really struggling. For all its money that Infosys has made for its stockholders, it has only made one product, Finacle.
Yeah.
And Finacle is the one that replaced LaserSoft And Finacle is the one that was exploited by all these banks to create LOUs without flagging the CBS, core banking system.
Right.
So the mindset in India is still not there where they can be encouraged to go and start a company. Today, many Silicon Valley startup companies have a branch in Chennai. But you know what that branch does? It's a QA of what the thing that's developed in Silicon Valley.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It will do scripting for QA. It will run the thing again and again and again and again. And that's most of the time, that's what they do. Very few groups have a system whereby 5 or 10 employees will be taken from Chennai. They'll be brought to Silicon Valley. So they understand how to pick up the pace and run.
Right.
And then they come back and that's how they improve the quality. These things
if adequate funds are there, it should not be a problem to generate it, right?
It's not. It should not be a problem to generate it. I think some more thinking is required, but I'm sure this is going to start happening now. India just has far too much talent that will, somebody is going to say, I'm going to figure out a way to make this thing happen. And I think we will leave it at that. If you would like to add something else, please go ahead.
Because I did talk to some, what you may loosely call big business in India. The owners also, everybody was telling, no, it requires huge investment and that type. I didn't want to argue or anything, right?
5 people is all you need for a startup.
Starting this type of thing, social media, they were arguing that, I didn't want to, maybe I think either inclination is not there or maybe it's something new, completely new product line. So let's not try to that. Or maybe that, they want, typical Indian thing, like, 2 to 3 years, we would like to get back what we are investing or something. Or as one put it, why get into all this? Because it will create controversy. Somebody will criticize the government and this and that. So that could be a very damaging type of a thing for them, possibly. But one thing I visualize, or rather, I think the print media time is over. Already their sales have come down. Many people are not, because there is no need to buy it. You can always read the news either in the TV or you can read it.
Right.
That is one thing. Second is the reading habits are also completely changing. Three is this, everybody being an editor is really fascinating. Actually. I don't know. All, it's a free for all as of now, actually. Anybody can write anything and then, and get it done, and some criticism may be there. Another thing, obviously, in the process, there is a lot of abusers and a lot of what one can call attacking each other without any civility. Another thing, maybe these are initial stages, I think, as and when things shape up. But one thing I am very, very confident, future is that of the social media. There is no other way. There could be some sort of a self regulation or something could. Emerge out of all these things, right?
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much, Professor.
Yeah.